You were right.
This is definitely better than being at work. One thing he didn't warn us about, though. Bloody midges.
Your big girl's blouse. Anyway, now that you've mentioned work, and seeing as I bullied you to come all the way out here to celebrate the fact, here. Congratulations. No knight should be without his sword.
I don't know what to say.
But my writer, lost for words.
It's perfect.
Yeah, and it's also solid silver, so don't lose it.
You evaded capture for 22 hours and 47 minutes. Go straight to the head of the class.
What's the real trick to survival?
Lies not in running and hiding, but in removing your enemy's capacity to hunt you down. Here, shoot the dog.
Sorry, sir. What?
Take the weapon and use it. During the selection process, you are under my command. That's a direct order, Cooper.
You're taking the piss, right?
He thinks I'm pulling his leg. Do I look like a shutting comedian? Shit, why?
No, sir! Still won't do it.
You don't have a choice. Finish the job. Shoot the dog.
Shoot it! No, sir!
What use are you to my team if you can't even kill a dog?
I didn't say I couldn't kill a dog, sir. I just will not kill that dog for no reason.
You're binned, Cooper. I don't need a man of conscience.
You're failing me for this!
You failed yourself!
We're on a different level here, Cooper. For that, I need men of action. Not deeds.
No! You sick fucking bastard!
It's just a dog, that's all. Maybe one day when that's sunk into your thick skull, you'll be ready for us. Until then, you live and learn.
Yeah, you don't.
I don't do second chances, Cooper. And I never forget. Or to you, this pathetic piece of shit. Send him back to his squad.
Position and bearing. I want to be the move in 3 minutes.
On it, Sarge.
Spook, Terry, you're on stag. Joe, for fuck's sake, get off your big fat lardy ass and make like a soldier. Right then. Time sink. I've got 0730 coming up in 3, 2, 1. Oh, check.
Bollocks, I don't believe this.
What is it now, Witherspoon?
Fleffy, watch at the barracks, Sarge.
Take a breather every once in a while, son. You live longer.
Nice work, Spoon, you tosser.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
And you'll be taking my boot out your mouth in a minute, Joe, you baldy twat.
Pissing hell.
Close save, eh, Jet?
Oh, this site is totally bone. The most important football match of my life is playing tonight, and I'm stuck up the backside of beyond without so much as a six-pack or a telly.
Yeah, well, that's the army for you.
Hey, it's England v Germany, man. Full-on footy war.
Yeah, well, it's nothing like this at all, then, is it, Joe?
It's just an exercise. Hardly life or death.
Don't bet on it, Joe. You're fucking slaying me.
If you paid any attention at all during the briefing, Kirkley, you'd know exactly who we were up against on this harmless little exercise, wouldn't you?
And who's that, then?
Special Forces, you plonker.
Well, bollocks to them.
All right, all right. Now, listen up. I'm going to make this quick and to the point, because just like you, all I want to do is get home, jump into a warm bed with a nice hot woman and watch the footy.
Planning on scoring, Sarge?
Yeah, well, mind you don't foul her in the penalty box.
Oh, all right, button it, Private Parts. Now, as of this moment, as far as we're concerned, we are 50K behind enemy lines. Now, if we do happen to make a contact, I expect nothing less than gratuitous violence from the lot of you. Because we're firing blanks, it doesn't mean we have to be thinking nice thoughts. So you remember, you put the fire down, right? You get stuck in and you kick their fucking teeth out. Or I guarantee you, Joe, they will be having your bollocks for breakfast, sunshine.
Hard boiled or fried, Sarge?
Scrambled. Yeah, Spoony.
Oh, smart.
So because it's nice and new and shiny doesn't mean it's worth shit. Remember, I want that back, son.
What about you, Sarge?
Well, I'll count, won't I? Right then, Coop, what we got? Oh.
We're here. The front line is here. AWACS reports enemy positions here, here and here. With sweeping patrols between each of these forward bunkers, they'll have the whole sector wrapped tighter than an Eskimo's nadsack. With one exception, right here. A river crosses the line through a gorge 30 or 40 feet deep. And it's certain to have a patrol on it, but if we go at night, tread careful and don't mind getting our feet wet, I reckon we can make it through.
The fuck is all this about, then?
Well, my luck lately, I need all the help I can get.
You listen to me. I know you think it was a piss-poor call, you failing selection and all of that, but I've got to say I'm not sorry. The squad would be a lot worse off without you, mate.
Something I had to do, you know. For myself, get out of my system.
Listen, the only people who go looking for trouble are kamikazes, glory boys, and full-on fucking fuckwits. Take my advice, son. Patient. Right then, ladies! Pack up your troubles, put your brains in first gear and start tabbing. Spoonie, you're on point. Terry, Joe, tail end Charlie's.
Over here, Cooper, on me head. Oh, yeah, twatter. I can't believe I'm missing the footy for this party.
Joe, if you don't shut up, I swear to God, I'm gonna fucking slot you myself. Now move.
Didn't say a word, Sarge. Hell are we now?
Cracking story about this place.
You what?
People disappear out here. Happens all the time.
Go on, Cooper. I'd give it some bollocks.
It's true. Just last month, a young couple were hiking through these woods. They set up camp somewhere near here. During the night, something happened. Mountain rescue team found the remains of the camp a couple of days later. The tent was ripped to shreds and there was blood everywhere. The paper said it was a monster like the beast of Bodmin Moor. Locals claimed it was an escaped lunatic. But no one's been caught, so nothing could be proved either way. Every year, more and more people come through here. Every once in a while, they don't come back. No trace, no bodies, just disappear. And never seen again.
Contact camp. Tell them the flock is heading for the fold.
Well then, Bruce, what scares you?
The self-destructive nature of the human condition.
Just taking a piss now.
What do you think, sir?
How about you then, Spoon?
Castration.
Yeah. There's no argument there. Joe?
Only one thing guaranteed to put the shits at me. A penalty shootout.
Figures. Teddy?
Watching a penalty shootout. With Joe.
What about you, Coop?
Spiders. And women. And, spider women.
I want to know what scares a Sarge.
Piss off, man. Nothing scares a Sarge.
I don't know about that. I thought I'd never see my wife again. Scares the shit out of me. That and those little things that make your skin crawl. And the hairs stand up the back of your neck.
You mean like Spoon?
No, there's one thing actually in particular that I remember till the day that I die. Yeah, it's back in 91, just before my unit was flown out to Q8 to mop up the last pockets of resistance. Me and this young fella called Eddie Oswald decided to go and get a tattoo done to commemorate our first trip into the desert.
I remember Eddie. He was a stocky hard case with a broken nose and a bong eye, eh?
Yeah, that's him. Good looking fella. Big hit with the ladies. Anyway, me and Eddie, we went out a few drinks. We had a lot of drinks. And we went down to the tattoo parlor and I got a desert rat done. And Eddie, being Eddie, wanted something with a bit more meaning. And being a bit of a believer, he said that his soul still belonged to God. But his flesh was way beyond redemption. And it was up to Satan to save his skin. So he got this fucking great laughing devil tattooed right on his arse. Anyway, about 6 days later, we were making a regular sweep along the Iraqi border. And Eddie, poor fucker, triggered an anti-tank mine. Yeah, we all saw it happen. I mean, he was on point. White, blinding, lightning flash, and a fucking deafening crack. And by the time we picked ourselves up off the deck, Eddie was... he was gone. Just bits and pieces of him. It's all that remained. This big fucking red circle, 100 metres. I'll tell you something, lads. It really puts things in perspective when you have to scoop your mate up with a shovel and stick him in a bin bag. Anyway, the thing that really did our nuts in that day was when you came across a bit you recognised. Bit of ear, toe and nose, a tooth. The thing that really freaked us out that day was when left-hand Charlie found a bit of Eddie with a tattoo on. I mean, everything else was burnt to a crisp, covered in claret, all mushed up, pulped up. Not this bit. This bit was perfect. And there's old Nick chalking his fucking arsehole off at us. So you could say that Eddie was right, that Satan did indeed save his skin, just not all of it. Or you could say that Eddie was just unlucky. Either way, it taught me to keep a very open mind. Boom, boom. Anyway, Eddie Oswald.
To Eddie.
To Eddie.
So anyway, this bloke walks into a pub, right, with a dog under his arm, puts us down on the bar, goes and sits down. The bartender's looking at him thinking, what the fucking hell's going on here? Then he looks back at the dog, and to his surprise, the dog turns around and says,
fucking cow!
Fucking hell!
Cease fire, Terry! Cease fire!
Terry, what the hell are you doing? You're firing blanks, man.
Is everyone all right? Is everyone okay?
No, man, I think I've shit myself.
Is it dead?
Oh, yeah, it's dead, all right.
Just look at the state of it.
Oh, God, man, look at the state of Terry.
These aren't entry wounds. More like teeth marks.
You saying, Cooper? What he's saying, Terry, is it died of natural causes, mate.
Don't you think we should call us in, Sarge?
Aye. Get on the radio, Bruce.
Now, there's no way I'm about to break radio silence because you lot got spooked by a dead fly fucking cow. No, we hold this position. We keep it secure till the morning. Then we reassess the situation. Right, so I want a watch posted. 214 off. Brucey, Spoon, you're up first. Keep an eye relieve at 0100 hours. And in the meantime, Terry, sort your kit out. The rest of you get your heads down. Unbelievable.
Cow came in from this direction, straight off the edge.
Out of the frying pan onto the fire.
Bleeding to death, it could have wandered around for miles before I got here.
Yeah, well, it's good of it to leave some breadcrumbs for us to follow, eh?
Looking for trouble.
No, Cooper. Just looking.
Sarge, shouldn't we just report this when we get back?
Too fucking right, Terry, but in the meantime, I'm curious. It's on the way.
Come on, lads.
Causes my ass. Oh, now what?
Christ on a bike.
What the fucking hell happened here, Sarge?
This is getting more boring by the minute.
Oh, Jesus Christ, Sarge.
All right, lads. Get a grip. We've got casualties to locate. So, ditch your Bergens.
Salvage whatever weapons you can find and stand to. We are now up against live hostile targets. So, if little Red Riding Hood should show up with a bazooka and a bad attitude, I expect you to chin the bitch.
Looks like they got hit hard and fast. Every magazine is full. Nobody got off a single round.
If they're lost, then where are the bodies?
Yeah. All right, Corporal. Get on the net and call in. I want emergency airlift immediately.
I'm on it.
Ah! Shit! Contact! Contact!
Help me.
Captain? Ryan? What happened here?
Do not tell me you fucking know him.
Captain Ryan, Special Ops.
Fucking dumb lover.
Spearhead Patrol, this is Spearhead Patrol. You're receiving.
You look like he took on Jack the Ripper and came last.
I can patch him up, but he needs a medic right now.
This is emergency, code 64.
You've got to get me out of here. Do you understand? And there was only supposed to be one.
We're working on it, Captain.
Sarge.
Not now, Spoon.
You're receiving. Shit.
What's wrong, Bruce?
Can't find a signal. Did you check it? Of course I checked it, and I double-checked it, and it worked fine.
All right, Bruce, stay on it, see what you can do. Terry, this team must have had their own comms kit. Have a look around, see if you can find it. Go.
Sarge.
Spoon, have a shifty around the camp. See if you can find anything else useful.
Yeah, but...
Not now, Spoon!
This is Spearhead Patrol. Are you receiving me?
It was only supposed to be one.
Jesus. Charnel House is compromised to fuck. How's he doing here?
All I know is he's Special Forces. But if this is part of our exercise, they're not advertising. No cap badge, no insignia, just tags.
What, you mean some kind of covert action?
Covert action or not? They're packing all kinds of weird shit. Tranquilizer darts, nets, you name it. This is less like a special ops mission, more like a fucking safari.
Sarge, I found that radio.
Oh, shit, I don't believe it.
There was only supposed to be one!
What's he on about, Sarge?
Terry, get back on stag now.
You've got to get me out of here before they come back.
Who, Captain? Who is going to come back?
They tore them to pieces in front of my eyes.
There's often one, Sarge. If you don't get him somewhere warm soon, he's going to die of hypothermia.
Stay with the captain. Captain, Ryan, stay with me.
Sarge,
not now, Spoon.
I don't know if you care, but in about half an hour, it's going to be dark.
Does anybody copy?
Any joy?
Fuses are blown.
You fix it.
Well, maybe it was faulty, or maybe some damp dry in the casing bits fried the circuits.
Well, it's useless, mate, bin it.
Yeah. I also found this. It's attached inside, not part of the radio. Looks like a transmitter.
Why would they put a bug in our radio?
It's the Kobayashi-Maru test. They fixed it so we can't fucking win.
Button it, Spoon. No, Terry, it's probably some joke. I didn't want Joe to hear the footy results.
Nah, an early shot.
Miss Grange, anything useful?
Weapons, ammunition, a couple of magnesium flares. That's about it, the rest is fucked.
Right, lads, ditch your 80s. From here on in, the exercise is well and truly over. Anyone not carrying live rounds had better do so.
Bruce.
It won't make any difference. They won't die.
Yeah, well, this gives me a bit of peace of mind, sir.
You want peace of mind? Run for your lives before they tear your legs from under you.
Now you just shut up like a good gentleman. You are scaring my lads.
What the fuck?
Christ.
Oh, shit.
All right, lads. Grab what you can. Head for the tree line. We're moving. Let's go.
Yo.
I need a volunteer for rear guard action.
I'll do it.
Nice one. When we're clear, you fall back. We're going to be there to cover you. Right, off you go. Bruce, no heroics. Right, Spoony, you're on point. Joe, help Ryan. Terry, you're up next. Coop, you win me. Right, lads, let's have it through the long grass. Double time. Go. Come on, sunshine. Fucking shift it.
Jesus! Kemper, get out of it! Jesus, I'm pinned, mate!
He said no heroics, you bloody hypocrite. Oh, Jesus. Where's Bruce?
He's all over there. They fucking tore him apart. You piss off. That is an order. Incoming! Back off!
You can take your orders and shove them up your ass.
Oh, Jesus. My guns are out, goon.
Well, we'll just put them back in again.
They're not going to fucking fit.
Of course they'll fit, man. Here. Come on. Oh, come on. Come on.
Coming up a four-player flag.
God. My God.
To your rear!
Target! Target!
Keep moving! Covering fire!
We're under a flanking position!
They're sampling us!
Covering fire!
Coming from!
Target!
Thank you.
It's okay. What happened?
What happened? We were attacked by huge fucking howling things, that's what!
You were lucky I found you. I was about to give up hope.
And you were here?
I heard gunfire last night. I knew someone was out there, but if you weren't already in trouble, then you soon would be.
We are. Two men are down. Both need medical attention, but we need to dress the Sarge's wounds before we can take him too far.
There's only one farm in this glen, but the owners are friends. We can take your men there.
Stand back.
Pigs, little pigs. We've come to nick your video.
Clear.
What the fuck happened back there, Cooper?
I don't know, mate. She might have some answers.
Clear upstairs.
Where the hell are we now? Home sweet home.
Set him down. Spoon, get a field dressing on that wound. Terry, keep an eye out front. Is there a telephone here?
What? No.
Still hot, lads.
Wait, you can't just help yourself.
I'm chin-strap and I'm bloody starving. Can't help myself.
It's the training, miss. Never waste an opportunity to eat. Come on.
See? Now look what I'm doing.
Get it down your necks, lads.
Oh, top grub, what is it?
Don't know, mate. Looks like pork.
Yeah, well, leave some for us, you greedy mongrels.
Miss, where is the nearest phone?
50 miles as the crow flies.
What about the nearest population centre?
You mean a town? Well, Fort William, but it's at least a 4-hour drive back the way we just came. Do you think your wounded can make it?
We have to try. The Sarge is in serious trouble if we don't. You seem to know these roads. Will you take us?
Right now.
Well, unless your friends have just gone walkabout, this place may be compromised.
Fine. Sooner the better. Let's go.
All right. Spoon, on me. Everyone else, hang back that we bring the car about. Joe, help Sarge. Terry, watch him. Safety's off. Don't stare back.
I can't help it.
Go!
Don't let you rat
you! That puts a kibosh on that plan.
That was my car!
Shut the dog up!
Stamp him here!
What's happening?
Turn it right forward, cover the window!
For Christ's sake, anyone, get it ready!
Oh, Christ!
That's bloody charming, that is. You incompetent moron!
Do you want to have a fucking go, like?
Yeah. Bathroom.
Upstairs. Far end of passage.
We need to talk, Ryan.
Doesn't look like I'm going anywhere, does it?
Joe, Spoon, looks like we're staying. You know what to do. I want a secure perimeter with a clear field of fire, but give them something inviting. Right?
I want it.
Terry, you okay?
Got a real craving for a kebab?
I'll take that as a yes. Look, we've got limited ammunition. When you get as many pots and pans as you can lay your hands on, fill them with water and keep them on the boil, all right? Terry, where you're at, stick the kettle on. Could all do with a brew.
Terry! Get on with this.
Other side. Ah, you fool.
You came here because of them, right?
I don't have a fucking clue what they are, and right now I don't really care.
What are you doing here?
This was supposed to be a routine training exercise, and that's all.
So this wasn't a rescue mission?
What?
No, I guess not.
Back door secure.
It's not running out there, Spoon.
Well, they're still moving around out there, but they're keeping the distance, staying within the tree line.
Maybe they've had enough for one night.
Not likely. They're smart. You've seen what they can do. My guess is they're doing exactly what you'd be doing in their shoes. They're working as a team, looking for a weakness, a way in.
I'm not about to second-guess these things. They're the enemy, simple as that.
This is no ordinary enemy.
You know what this reminds me of? Rourke's Drift. 100 men of Harlech making a desperate stand against 10,000 Zulu warriors. Outnumbered, surrounded, staring death in the face, not flinching for a moment. Balls of British steel.
You're bloody loving this, aren't you? It's totally bone. That's all there is to say.
What are we talking about here, wolves?
Not entirely wolf. Nor all human, but something in between.
Wolf men. I'm gonna laugh, right? I may be nuts, but I'm no fruitcake.
Fine. Stay here and drink tea. I thought you might be here because of them, but I guess not. Just don't be an arsehole.
I like a new girlfriend, Coop.
How you feeling?
Touch of gas. And the fact that various body parts trying to vacate the premises. Fucking awful.
Tart. Cheers.
Heads up!
For crying out loud, man!
Short, controlled bursts.
Do you have a name, soldier?
Cooper. Gonna need your help here, miss.
My name is Megan. And I know how to kill...
Shit, Sarge, you're leaking like a slave. Look, I need to get some super glue and some whiskey, all right?
I'll see what I can do.
Come on.
No.
Sorry about the arsehole thing. I've got a mean streak a mile across.
Sorry. At least I'm not worried right now.
Can you pass me my gun, please? Thank you. Come on, Coop.
Yeah.
Up the wooden hill. Where are we going, Coop?
You don't want to know, Nick. You don't want to know.
What's the glue for?
Ever wonder why the best thing is super glue sticks together is your fingers?
Give it.
Forget your grandma's china cups. This stuff was developed for the Vietnam War to patch up broken soldiers. How you feeling, Sarge?
Absolutely fucking top fucking bollocks.
Give it.
I'm sure you should be chasing painkillers with whiskey.
No, he's armed it.
Is it your birthday, Coop?
No, mate.
Is it my birthday? Hey!
No. Are you going to thank us for this in the morning?
I'll tell you something, mate. I'm going to fucking thank you right now. I'm going to thank you because you saved my life. You got me out of there, mate.
Oh, you would have done the same thing.
If I'd done the same fucking thing, I would have saved Bruce, wouldn't I? Yeah. Fuck! Sausages. I'll tell you something, miss, right? This skeezer here, right, is my best mate. He's a salt of the fucking earth. I mean, don't get me wrong, the rest of the geezers in the squad, they're all right, lovely fellas and stuff, and any single one of them married my... married my sister. If I had one. I'll tell you what, I love him. I love you! Like the mate that I love.
Would you like to be alone?
Oh, yeah! Dirty fucker!
Here.
That's the adrenaline.
I'll stick. You bomb.
I'll tell you something, someone better get fucking stuck in soon, because it's really starting to hurt. Cooper. Oh. Knock me out! Hit me! Oh, you fucking pussy, hit me!
Go. So how long you lived around here?
2 years. Came here for the wildlife. I'm a zoologist.
So you've heard those stories as well, then?
Yeah, I heard the stories. I went looking. I found evidence. I was fascinated by the possibility...
You can't seriously believe in werewolves.
Straight out of college, I'd have laughed at the suggestion, but now I know they're as real as you and me. Before tonight is over, you will too. There. I think that'll hold.
You done this before?
Oh, yeah. We glue people's guts together all the time out here.
Everyone tooled up?
To the nines.
I'm fucking eye over that, man. Hey, Terry. Look sharp. The rest of you, I know things have gone from shit to bone to worse in the last 24 hours, but if we pull our weight and do the job, we still have a fighting chance. No more running. We stand here and we fight. Right? Any questions?
No, just the one, Coop. Exactly what is it we're fighting against?
Megan, you want to run it past the boys?
Lycanthropes.
You what?
That's werewolves to you and me.
Taking the piss.
What? Makes perfect sense to me.
What, you mean like full moons, silver bullets and eyebrows that join in the middle?
Before you dismiss it offhand, think about what you've seen and heard. The full moon, the teeth, the claws, the howling. Is it so difficult to believe? For a whole year now, I've tracked these things. I've studied them, tried to understand them. Every month, when the moon is full, they hunt as a team, dedicated to the kill. During that time, at least 15 people have vanished. Hikers mostly, in small groups or alone. They're caught out in the open, hunted down, torn apart, and devoured.
I've never witnessed the actual slaughter, but the next day, no bodies, no werewolves, just blood. The eyebrows thing is nonsense. It's just dark age paranoia. And silver bullets, no one's ever got close enough to try.
I'm sold.
Slow down, Spoon. Though Megan may have a point, I'm still not convinced that these things didn't just escape from the local nut house and forget to shave or trim their nails. But they're out there and we're in here. What they may or may not be does not affect our immediate situation one bit.
This is bone. This is so fucking bone!
Anything else?
Yeah. What does bone mean?
Bone. Bollocks. Naff.
Not very good.
Right. Anything else I should know?
Call signs, if you need to be specific. Upstairs, you've got Sergeant Wells, who you seem to know inside and out by now. You've got Spoon over there, the vomiting cavalier, Terry. The big guy with the axe is Joe.
Couldn't you forget someone?
Ryan. Captain Ryan is not one of our team.
His being here is hazy at best.
If I could tell you, I would. But I'm just a soldier. Like you.
No stripes. No insignia. A suit in a uniform does not make a soldier. He's with special ops. His team were wiped out last night. He was the only survivor.
I'd advise you against pursuing this line of questioning, Private Cooper.
Are you pulling rank on me now, Captain?
You can shove that right up your arse.
I'm saying my being here is a moot point, since I'm now in as much shit as you are.
We're all in the same fucking shit. And we need each other.
I doubt I need you.
You bloody did 2 hours ago.
The U.S.
Crying like a baby you were.
That was then. Circumstances change.
What?
Uath. It's Celtic. The family has lived in this glen for centuries. So what was he doing out there?
I have an idea. I want to hear it from the horse's mouth. Come to think of it, Ryan, how are you feeling?
I'm fine.
When we found you, you could barely open your eyes, let alone walk, and then later you managed to run, and now look at you. Fighting fit and sitting pretty. Hardly the behaviour of a man who, until recently, was knocking on death's door.
I have a strong constitution.
You're not bloody kidding.
You won't mind if I have a look at that wound of yours.
I just assume you didn't.
I have a responsibility to my patient.
I'm warning you, Cooper, don't touch me.
Get
back!
Tie him up. I want him to talk.
What are you gonna do? Torture him?
Dunno. What would you do?
I'd torture him.
What now?
To shut down the generator.
Why would they do that?
Because they can see in the dark.
And you're afraid of it.
This is a pile of rancid shit!
Now what do you believe?
I'm beginning to believe you. I think Joe might have worded it better.
They're on the move.
All right, this is it. Mark your targets and preserve your ammo. 3-round bursts. Only got one stun grenade apiece, so only use them if absolutely necessary. Stand to.
What can I do?
What do you want to do?
Run and hide. I know what's coming.
Take care of Sam. Keep an eye on Ryan. If he tries anything, pan him.
Chasing that first kiss, are we, Cooper?
It's as simple as this. If you're not there for us, we're not here for you.
Cheers, mate.
Dogs. More like pussies.
You all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm peachy, mate. Squad's yours, mate.
Took Terry.
Let me go and get him back.
Too fucking right.
Forget about him.
What did you say?
He's dead, Cooper, and you know it.
Somebody must have heard some gunfire. Somebody must have heard something.
Who? The only other house within 50 miles of here is mine, and I'm not there.
Well, what about the road, man? Passers-by.
Do you have any idea what kind of luck you had running into me out there tonight?
I thought you ran into us.
Joe, check upstairs.
Even if anyone did come by, they'd only end up lands for the slaughter like you. Our only hope is daylight. Sun rises in 6 hours.
We did the best we could. But if the Sarge's condition deteriorates, he'll have less than four. And the only thing holding them back is they don't know how much ammunition we have left. Let's have a look at that.
Tell me, honestly, what are our chances?
Morale seems good, considering. But that'll only last as long as the ammunition holds out. High spirits are just no substitute for 800 rounds a minute, but I don't think that's what you want to hear.
Think about it, Cooper. Up until today, you believed there was a line between myth and reality. It may have been a very fine line sometimes, but at least it was a line. Those things out there are real. And if they're real, what else is real? You know what lives in the shadows now. You may never get another night's sleep as long as you live.
So why worry, Cooper? You may not live that long.
Shut your mouth. We're not going to make it through this. You know why? I don't scare that easy.
Yeah.
Supposed to be lucky.
For me or the rest of the rabbit?
You'll need a lot more than luck this time.
Shut up, Ryan! Listen to me, Cooper. Ignore him. We can survive till sunrise. That's all that matters. It's just a few more hours.
Wait a minute. Am I missing something here?
I know him. I was seconded to his team during their first visit here.
First visit? What first visit? What the fuck are you talking about?
They came to check out the stories. They needed an expert. It's just a few more hours, Cooper. That's all it is.
All clear?
Yeah.
You want to kill them all?
Yes.
Good, keep it up. What's the damage, Spoon?
Well, we might have pissed on our chips. We've only got two full mags for the MP5s, six rounds for the shotgun, and one spare, just in case.
Stay sharp, everyone.
Fire down all over. I mean, we filled those things with lead and they just kept on getting up and coming back at us. 60 rounds, man, they're gonna last 2 minutes.
So either we all make a break for it and fight our way clear, or the rest of us keep them occupied while one of us goes for help.
By the time the cavalry get here, they'll have to pick what's left of us from between their fucking teeth. Fucking brilliant. We either stay and snuff it or we all go and snuff it.
Decisions, decisions.
Laugh. I nearly died.
Who's stopping you?
Why, that's it! We'll fucking have him!
Take it easy, big man. Calm down.
Do any of you know how to hotwire a car?
What?
They keep an old Land Rover in the barn. I don't know where the keys are, but if one of you could break in and start it, then...
I can do that.
Are you sure?
Piece of piss. Anyway, the further I am from this wanker, the happier I'll be.
All right. You're gonna need a decoy. Something fast and loud.
What? You what?
You sit. Stay.
You're serious about this werewolf thing, aren't you?
Afraid so.
Shit. Don't suppose you know who won the match?
I didn't even know there was a game on.
It's not a game.
Right, this is it. Everyone get ready.
Bollocks.
Joe. Good luck, mate.
You don't get off the hook that easy.
Thank you.
right, you bastards! Come and have a go if you think you're hard enough! Well, come on, you beauty!
They took the bait.
Come on!
No, run! Move your fucking arse, soldier!
Trying!
Pull it!
I love it when a posh bear talks dirty.
Jesus!
Fucking hell!
Fuck him, what's happening, Cooper?
Go.
bad way. Fuel pump's gone, fan belt's bugging, she's pissing out petrol like there's no tomorrow.
The word bone springs to mind.
Joe's body.
It's gone. What's the damage, Spoon?
We're down to 48 rounds.
Check the right. Well, Ryan, you heard the score. Maybe one or two of us are going to make it through this. I don't care much for our chances. Do you like football?
What? They think it's all over and all that crap. No, I don't.
Well, Joe, you remember Joe? He liked football. Fucking lived for it.
Is this relevant?
He missed the most important match of his life for this bullshit exercise, and now he's dead. Along with two other mates, I'd have readily given my right arm for two fucking right. It's relevant!
You just can't get past the dog, can you?
We're losing, Ryan. We're 3-0 down, and we're close to the final whistle. At the very least, I want to even the score.
I understand your resentment. But you failed because you weren't prepared to take that extra step. If you passed, you would have been on my team, and if you were on my team, you'd be dead.
Yeah, I failed. And I'm bloody glad of it. Because given the choice of taking orders from a toffee-nosed twat like you and slogging it out with these guys, I'll take the underdogs any time, so you can take your precious selection, shove it up your arse, and stop trying to change the fucking subject!
Fair enough. But you won't like what I have to tell you. There are some places you really shouldn't go.
We'll be the judge of that, Ryan.
Ever heard of Special Weapons Division? They're the men in white coats who train dolphins to stick mines on submarines and cute furry animals to tear your head off at the neck. They saw an opportunity and called me in.
To do what? Catch one of these things?
And to bring it back. Alive, if possible.
Only it turned out to be them.
We underestimated enemy numbers.
Underestimated? I'd have a serious word with your head sheds about the quality of their intelligence.
It may have been their invitation, but it was my party. I planned and executed it.
And you loused it up. We lost good men, Ryan. Yours and mine. I want to know where we fit in.
The reality is, you're expendable. And I had approval to put you at risk.
Get to the fucking point, Ryan.
I made a gap in enemy lines. You were good enough to spot it and predictable enough to go for it. That was your bait. You were mine.
You bastard.
I had to choose somebody. I remembered you. Monkey see, monkey do.
They were my men!
Get up, you shit. You know what we can do. Give us a fighting chance!
You can learn, Cooper.
Whoa. I didn't hit him that hard.
You shook something loose.
Dog.
Werewolves spend most of their time in human form, right? And the only people for miles around live right here.
So these things aren't about to give up the fight and go home?
They are home.
Yeah, well, that makes perfect sense, doesn't it? I mean, think about it. We bust into their house, we eat all their porridge, we sleep in their fucking beds. No wonder they're pissed off.
But they're good people. They're kind people.
More's the pity.
Why?
So we're going to have to kill them all.
It's all right, mate.
Self-respecting werewolf would have anything silver in the house anyway.
Yeah, well, fuck the folklore. Let's just burn them.
Yeah.
Think you want to find them?
Maybe we do. Everything we've seen so far suggests the behaviour of a pack. 6 to 8 members, an alpha pair leading the subordinates, and a young male, a beta wolf, second in command. Makes sense.
Yeah, you lost me.
A wolf pack sticks together, generally somewhere close to its food supply. Somewhere safe, sheltered, and warm.
You're gonna have to move like shit off a shovel on this one, mate.
Oh, you worry about your own shit, Luke. You blow that fuse, that place is gonna go up like Zabriskie Point. Just make it work.
Yeah, it's easy peasy.
And lemon squeezy.
Listen, cool. What about the Sarge?
What about the Sarge?
You know what I mean?
Sarge is with us.
Yeah, I just didn't want him to go without getting his watch back.
You stay out of trouble.
Improvement on all of us.
No, you listen to me. You get the fuck out now. I hold them back, I keep them occupied, and you get out.
We've lost enough men for one night, don't you think?
Let me show you something. Now, do not tell me that that is fucking normal. What happened to Ryan is happening to me.
Wasting time with this Harry Carry crap. This fight isn't lost yet.
With Ryan, it only took a couple of hours, mate. It's a full moon. I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's like when you need to take a piss or something. I don't know. When you gotta go, you gotta fucking go.
Well, maybe it's more like needing a shite. Just because you need one doesn't mean you drop your kegs and pinch one off. Anyway, fuck Ryan. Shifty bastard could have been one of those things from the start.
You know, Coop, there's one more thing you've got to learn about command, mate. Sometimes the people that you kill are your own men. So I'm asking you, let me take care of myself. And at least spare you the unfortunate business of trying to explain to Annie why you had to incinerate me.
Gonna knock 7 colours of shit out of these fuckers. We need you.
It's all right, you know, mate. It's okay. I just didn't make it out this time, that's all. It goes to the job, do you know what I mean? When I signed my life away on that dotted line, I fucking meant it. I am a professional soldier.
roast their bollocks off.
All clear.
Good luck. When I found you out there tonight, I truly believed you were the best chance I had of getting out. But now we have no chance. There is no out. There never was. I came here to be at one with nature. Well, I got what I wanted. Now I have to live with it.
There is no house in the next glen.
No.
And there were no werewolves in the barn when it blew?
Not one.
And the reason you're not in the photographs, because you took it.
I never meant to...
New woman. Same old shite.
Being nice to women will get you nowhere, Cooper. Being nice to me will get you killed. You may think they're all bitches, but... I'm the real thing. Do you think I like being part of this fucked up family? Do you think I chose to run with the pack? No. I chose you. But now you're out of luck and I'm out of time. And all we can do is let nature take its course. They were always here. I just unlocked the door. It's that time of the month.
Sarge!
I'm in the car seat! I'm in the car seat!
Fucking wimp.
There is no spoon.
No, you fucking bastard!
Help me! Good for something!
It's one of the chamber, mate. Fucking binge!
Yeah. We gotta get out or we don't fucking go!
It's my last order, Chick. Do not fuck about! Do not disobey me!
Come here, you fuck! Fuck!
Listen, you have got to make it out alive. This happened. Not just for me, my lads.
Ryan, you tried licking your own balls yet?
I forgot. You don't fucking have any.
It's all over. It is now.
Oh!